Hello, malty, megalithic, malt-manipulating masters of the malt... macabre. Thank you to Bruce Bidwell. Yeah, thanks, Bruce, for that malt mention. This is the Bothy. I am Ralfy. We're talking about whisky at the moment, another quality spirits, but in particular, I'll start this video by announcing this is an extras, 819 extras. This is the review number, 819 extras, in which, having just reviewed a single malt in this occasion, it could be any other quality spirit, I'm now taking the opportunity to talk a little bit more generally about how you malt mates can get a richer, fuller, more detailed, deep experience and connectivity with your quality spirits, whatever they may be. And I don't do this very often, but I took this bottle from out of my personal whiskey collection because I received it 10 years ago when I got this presented to me as a gift from my colleagues at work for preparing them a Boxing Day dinner at work. And because I used to be a chef back in the days, although I didn't stay at it for long, it didn't suit me. I cooked them a pretty good dinner and they all chipped in and they went to the local shop and they bought me this bottle of Macallan. And I thought to myself, you know, I'm not going to open this. I'm going to write in the bottle a little legend, write in the box a little legend as to the date and the circumstances that I received this bottle as a gift. And then I am going to keep it till later. And a day will come along. It could be 1 year later, 10 years later, 20 years later, or even 30 years later. Perhaps never happen at all. But you never know, it's the way of life. But I knew that at some point I would open that bottle and enjoy it. And of course, it was 8 years after I received this bottle, 8 years later, that I started my Ralfy reviews in my original studio. Put this out of the way for the moment. So I never received this bottle as something that, well, I'll put that aside and I'll include it in a review later, because I never even knew at that point I was going to do reviews. I was that busy enjoying the whiskey chase, buying bottles of whiskey when people around me were spending a lot of money in carry out meals and football matches and upgrading their cars every 3 years and all that nonsense. You know, I had my car for 13 years because it was reliable. It was all I needed, and I saved my money basically to pay my mortgage off early, which I did. And I wasn't one for spending a lot of money in pubs. I'd go into a pub now and again and have a pint or two, and I talk about that in my book, Search for a Whisky Bothy, which I'll mention in a forthcoming video. And thanks to everybody who's bought it, by the way. I really appreciate it. But this was a bottle that I could have opened it, I could have enjoyed it, I could have shared it with friends, I could have taken it along to the whiskey club. But to be honest, at that point, the whiskey club was only just starting. In the 1990s, I'd already been buying some single malts, and the folk I worked with knew this because it was a topic of conversation and they thought I was a weirdo, which is absolutely fine because I'm a bit of a weirdo, but a nice one. And I wasn't basically being conventional, not a bit of it. And my holidays, by the way, occasionally I'd go somewhere exotic for a cultural visit. Japan, Egypt, China, Australia, a few European countries, which was fine, but most of all I liked being at home, because there's just so much on your own doorstep to enjoy. And I'd go trips into the Highlands and I'd come home in the evening, long day in the motorcycle, fire on. Always have the, even in summertime, put the fire on, get the flames going. Chill out, pour a dram, relax, knowing that you've got bottles remaining unopened in the stash for later. And when later arrives, you'll just instinctively know it. And I'm going to recommend you do this. Everybody who starts to get into whiskey is going to have a whiskey collection. It could be a collection of one bottle, but it's still a collection. But as we, but due to the fact that you don't need to finish one bottle before you buy the next, and you, obviously you're going to try different spirits just to develop your range of your palate, bourbon and rum and rye and all the rest of it. And at this point, you've got two or three bottles and more, and then you come across a bottle that you really, really enjoy, and instinctively, despite not having much experience with whiskey for particularly long, you're getting your bearings and you've got a feeling, you know, this is such a really good experience. I've bought one bottle, I'm going to buy two more bottles. It's not that expensive in the scheme of things. So when I buy these two other bottles, I've got one to keep and one to swap, or one swap or sell. You can sell it privately, an auction, whatever. It's just part of enhancing the hobby and making it bigger than it can be for many people. They're just content to have a bottle, finish it, and then move on. But it's a different age now. So, for example, those who saw the 15-year-old Glendronach revival when it appeared, you know, it's a different whiskey now. They're still good whiskey, but to have sealed bottles in your collection that you know for sure are really, really good, and when you open them in 5, 10, 15, 20, 30, 50 years' time, they're going to be equally as good as the day you bought it. You can leave instructions for your son or daughter or other members of your family or friends that after you pass away, if you're going to have a wake, there's a bottle, share it, remember me. What a great way to acknowledge people's friendship is to leave instructions. Here you are, this is a really good whiskey I bought 50 years ago. You're going to enjoy it. Remember me. It's real life. When we build up our collection, we've got to be careful how we look after it. Too many people make the mistake of putting their bottles of whiskey into cardboard boxes, into garages or roof spaces, which are far too hot. What happens is the constant fluctuation in temperature creates atmospheric pressure inside the bottle, and then it starts to push out the alcohol from the seal. It's inevitable. And with screw tops, every now and again, you've just got to put a tiny wee tighten, because the metal will loosen off over time. Just tiny, tiny little tighten up. Remember, you're tightening clockwise to tighten, anti-clockwise to open. Understand that. You don't want to be tightening your bottle with a screw top and suddenly discovered you've opened it, because if you do, you'll just have to drink it. Excuse me, dram time. My next review is going to be this. I bought it just 3 weeks ago. It's Macallan, 14-year-old. Bottled by Gordon MacPhail, 43%. It's the perfect whiskey to compare with an old official bottling. Not very often you see independent bottlings of Macallan. I was surprised to see it. I was surprised at the price as well. I just took a chance and I bought it. So I look forward to telling you all about it in my next review. Let's get this out the way now. I don't want to have an accident drop it. It's not served its purpose yet. So when you're building up your collection, you need to create space. You need a big cupboard or a small room, ideally a small room, that's going to be secure, and you put up your shelves and you put everything in order, and you have, as part of your collection, you have these standard available contemporary single malts which may change in the future. They might not, but they may change. And you want to have them as a reserve that you can come back to through a historic timeline. And then you can look back and say, I remember when I bought that. These are the people where I was with. This is the shop I bought it at. This is what my life was like. Here's a photograph of me then. It can be very, very nostalgic. And these things, by the smell and the taste, they're so emotive as senses that when you open that bottle and pour it, it will very much assist in taking you back to that moment in time, that historical moment when you bought that bottle and then you put it aside. What would I recommend off the top of my head? What whiskies would you buy now that may be different or maybe not around in the future? Well, let's start. I'd say a Springbank 10-year-old, definitely. One of them. Talisker. Glenfarclas, Isle of Arden, really anything at all that you've recently experienced that was of good quality. There's no point just buying a particular brand for brand's sake because it might not be a great version of it. Focus specifically in smell and taste quality, because these are whiskies you're putting aside primarily to smell and taste later on. In years or decades to come. It just adds a whole new dimension to your experience. It certainly worked an absolute treat for me. And here we are in the Bothy now, doing something that I never anticipated when I first bought this, when I first was given this bottle back in 2001 by my grateful colleagues at work for cooking them Boxing Day lunch. And it's open now, smelling it, tasting it, thoroughly enjoying it, and just, it's taking me back, blast from the past, aided and fueled and assisted by the smell and the taste of something that I could have opened then, but time wasn't right, the time's now, to mark the end, the conclusion of my 10th anniversary as a whiskey reviewer. We're now into the 11th year, and you know what's coming next. There'll be another version of Macallan. Hope you'll join me for that. I'm Ralfy, giving you a wee cheery wave, malt mates. Stay safe. Look after yourselves. Appreciate the basics and amplify the quality of your life by enjoying the seclusion and the solitude of your social distancing with some fine quality spirits. See you soon.